And welcome back, this is Baller Scuba with more Let's Play Xenoblade Chronicles. I'm joined, as always, by my mechanical squad of Dunban, Shulk, Charla, Ricky, Melia, Ryan, and Fiora. When we last left off, we made it into the Mechonis and went around the outside, but we're back inside, so I feel a little bit safer these days. I did change the party around just a little bit, so let's go over it rather quickly. I do have the Gemini boots on Shulk. Those are definitely new. I believe everything else is the same. Dunban does now have the Alcyone top, so that's definitely new. He looks so much more formal than he did before. Charla is on the Gemini armor that somehow gave her more clothing. That's rare for her. With Ricky, I'm not sure I changed too much, if anything at all. Melia did get sleek sandals, so she's kind of going full-on bathing suit the further I go along. Ryan did get a few changes as well. He's now on the Taurus Greaves, as well as the Charge Gear. I think everything else is the same. I could be mistaken about that. Lots of Gemini stuff going around, so maybe the Gemini leggings are new for him as well. With Fiora, F-Power boosters are new. They do look more powerful than her previous legs. Those look like brand new legs. They don't look like, well, clothing at all. But that is what I did with the equipment. Let's go over the arts, because I did a little bit of work with the arts. Nothing in the skills, but in the arts, I did level up Shadow Eye and Minato Enchant for Shulk, trying to get that effect time up mostly. With Dunban, I'm not sure, actually. I must have leveled up something. There we go. Soaring Tempest. We're starting to max things out, so it's a little bit strange for me to try to remember what I actually did. Just two more things to go? Then I'm gonna start needing books for Dunban. With Charla, I leveled up Shield Bullet and Heat Bullet. She has a lot of bullets. I'm trying to level them up. With Ricky, I leveled up Happy Happy. Also maxed out Behave. Once again, running out of things to do with Ricky. We still need some books, though. Even the intermediate stuff would be good for Ricky right now. With Melia, I couldn't do Summon Bolts. I was close, but not quite. I'll definitely max that out at some point. But instead, I worked on Summon Earth and Starlight Kick, and I believe Burst End. Summon Bolt's quite expensive. It was one or the other three, and I went with the other three this time. With Ryan, once again, we're getting close to finishing him off. I think that I put the points into Dive Sobat this time. Very, very close. And with Fiora, I think I'm done. I think I've maxed everything out that I can. That at least I want to. So everything should be maxed out for now. Once again, we're in need of books. The only thing that I was possibly thinking of doing was putting second gear instead of double blade, but to be honest, I can hold off that one skill for the time being. One art, I should say. Didn't do anything with the skill trees. We are ready to move forward. We need to head through this door. Before we do, I do want to point out that if you go through this door, I'm not going to necessarily say what happens, but you won't be able to go back to Sword Valley or Galahad Fortress. So if you want to go back to Sword Valley and Galahad Fortress, now would be a good time, because it might be the last time. Let's head forward. This does not necessarily look good. We got a long, narrow hallway with barriers at the end. And we've made it to the high velocity lift. This doesn't look good. If it's a slow moving elevator, there might be enemies. They did say high velocity though. This doesn't seem very high velocity to me. Is it gonna pick up the pace a little bit here? Maybe I'm just underestimating the velocity and how big everything on the wall is. That's always a possibility. It's not really picking up that much speed, but there are no enemies around here. They're breaking the rules of elevators. Elevators are death traps waiting to happen in RPGs. but we have made it up. I need to go that way. The arrow tells me that eventually. There's a long build up to this. I wonder what we'll find on the other side. Oh, look! Bad things are gonna happen. I can sense it. It's a sixth sense of mine. Oh my. Things aren't looking good for me. This is a huge build up to something on the end here. There's no machines, there's no machina, there's no Mechon, there's nothing going on this side. But we have made it to the first Xebri bulkhead. I know it's not necessarily a good time right now, but I'm gonna check skills again. That's 160 points that I got. Let's make sure I don't waste any of it. How close are you? I see like 17 points away. This is why I checked. Damn it, Charla. All right, she did finally get Ultimate Sniper, reduces the duration of cool-off. That did decrease her cool-off by 50%, which is very nice. Reduces cooldown of healing art, also going to be super good when I get it. Heavy equipment to be equipped? Not my favorite, but to be honest, it does work for Charla. I just prefer her having more ether defense because she's usually hanging out in the back. Then we have ether explosion, greatly increases ether. 75. Yeah, we're going to go with this one first. Then we'll come back to rapid healing. But for the time being, I want to take advantage of, well, it having less SP to learn. Anything else? Ryan, did I already have you there? Channeled pain, fills talent gauge when damage is taken. Yeah, that sounds all right. I'll have you finish that up. How many points do you have in that? Yeah. We'll keep going. All right, we're good. We are good. Let's head forward. I see a flag in the distance. And once again, like, bad things look up.
Are you okay?
She looks very tired. Should she not get some rest?
Oh, thank you. But really, I'm okay.
No. We'll find a safe place to rest. We've hardly stopped since we left the village.
Ricky tired too. Ricky tummy rumble.
I'm with you. Time to park our...
Get down! A Mechon assault! Can anyone see them?
Another vision! Nice one, Shulk!
No, it wasn't.
Shulk?
You did well to evade me. Just what you'd expect from he who wields the Monado.
That voice!
It's a faced Mechon!
Is there someone inside?
What do we do, Shulk?
We fight. But don't kill him.
Thought you might say that.
And we have ourselves a boss fight. I'm gonna keep the same party. It worked well for me before. Let's stick with it. We are up against...
I'm afraid you must be exterminated.
A new enemy here. So what do we have? We have a vision of Linear Laser 4 on Shulk. 3,000 damage and paralysis. Let's head this way.
I see it.
Linear Laser 4 on Shulk again. So it's a little weird of a fight. They're expecting me to hide behind these walls here, just kind of constantly. Alright, we'll go for the enchant. Oh, I did move Charlotte over to the Machina rifle. Not necessarily because it's good against Machina or Mechon, but because it's the best thing that she has available to her right now. That's the end of the story there. All right.
I see it.
Yeah, I know. There's going to be an attack. Linear Laser 4 on Shulk. They want you to hide behind the walls. That's the idea. So I have 16 seconds to make it to a wall. Hey, look, I found a wall. I don't like that I'm losing so much here. Yeah, I don't need to fight the defensive onions. Oh!
I see it.
Yes, I know. Linear Laser 4. Linear Laser 4 is coming. There's a guy over there that's shooting at me right now, though. I would rather deal with him. The M66 trick, he will not last long. Alright, let's make sure I'm in position. Alright, this is good. Get him now. Do we still have to do the enchant? We might still have to do the enchant. I'm not sure about this fight. It's a weird fight. It's different than any other boss fight that we have done to this point. As a result, the rules probably have changed a bit. No, that's the end there. Okay, so let's head this way. No vision this time. Can I just kill him? Dunban, what are you doing?
Let's focus our efforts.
Gotcha.
Dunban? Dunban just ran off. Is he coming back? Let's try to... Damn it, I keep on moving too far to see... He's way the hell over there. What is he doing? Where is he going? Is he... Oh, he's back. I have never seen this game bug out the way that it has for this Let's Play. He's off again! Is he going after the boss? Like, I'm not going for the boss just yet. That's why! Alright, he's going for the boss. We might as well head in for the boss then. Yeah, there's a vision. He's gonna do a linear laser. He does that a lot. You're supposed to be behind the walls when the lasers go off. But now it's on Dunban. Alright, Dunban! Do something. I leveled up Soaring Tempest. Why don't you do that? Yeah, at least hit some people with it. Shield. Did I get it off in time? I think I did. But now we're up against the boss, eventually, once I kill... Did that thing heal? That HP bar went up a little bit. Oh, I need to enchant again. Apparently that ran out. Like Dunban did on me. Alright. I'm gonna hit this guy. Screw it. I'm finishing off this guy. Can I hit both of them? We almost got it. Then we can talk about the boss. Boss is rather important after all. It's, it doesn't say his name right now. There we go. Level 60 Jade Face. Go for an eater. Get some more bleed on him. This fight's not really difficult. As long as you're properly leveled. Once you do 30% of its HP, you'll win.
Destruction of the Monado. That is the will of Lord Egil.
Gaddo?
What do you mean, Lord? What's Egil done to you?
What's wrong, Gaddo? Why would you say that? Speak to me, Gaddo!
This world is in disarray. I must eliminate the cause of this disorder and restore the world to its original form. That is my duty. Nay, the will of the world. Now, the time has come. The time to restore order.
Gaddo, stop!
The game asks if I want to save. I'll go ahead and say yes, although I do have... You know what? No, we're not going to save. I just saved. I do have some questions about why Fiora's eyes turned red and then she exploded. I have quite a few questions about that game. You gonna answer that for me? I figured out.
Lady Maynev. It is not far off now. A world in which there is no need for fear. The hour draws near. Our will shall soon be done. First, there is the matter of the Monado. Our victory can only be assured if we destroy the Monado before it's too late. I sense your existence. I know you are alive. Xanza, the hour is upon us. Your time has come.
Shit, did we power on the Mechonis? Xanz is still alive, though. I have more questions.
Shulk.
Who's calling my name?
Shulk, you have acquired the ability to glimpse the future. The ability to understand the law of causality as decided by a higher power.
A higher power? Like the Bionis.
Why do you desire to change the future? Why do you wish to act against their will?
I do just as anyone would do. It is natural to want to change an unhappy future. If that is their will, then I choose to fight.
If that is what you wish, Shulk, then you must find your Monado.
My Monado.
Precisely. The one true Monado.
You can't do that. Because you aren't here. Not anymore.
Damn it, game, these cutscenes are just designed to confuse me, aren't they? What are you on about? How many Monados are there?
Is everyone okay?
Yeah.
That was a close one. I mean, how on Bionis did we survive that? We seem all right.
I don't know. It could be that we were just lucky. But I'm sure there must be more to it than that.
You were protected by the power of Lady Maynith.
Who's there?
A machina. Are you... Vanaya?
Vanaya? Does that mean you're... Mikol's daughter?
I am glad you are safe, Lady Maynith.
Lady Maynith?
That face was sent to destroy you. I am truly happy you are all right.
You're lying. Gaddo would never try and hurt us.
Sadly, his home's memories no longer remain. The current faces are nothing more than weapons, designed to annihilate all life on Bionis.
It can't be.
Faces are created by directly integrating the brainstem and metabolic organs of Homs into Mechon.
Memories and emotion are nothing but a hindrance to an effective weapon. However, the early faces were experimental. Many retained memories from their former lives. This prevented them from executing their missions effectively. More recent faces have had all memories of their previous lives completely erased.
Is that because of me?
No, it is not your fault.
Munkar seems the more likely candidate. His attachment to us was too strong. You could say it caused his destruction.
That sword, one and all.
You are correct.
No, it's not true. Oh, my Gaddo.
Sharla? Explain it to me. I mean, why does Egil want to make us into Mechon? What's the reason for all this?
In order to counter the Monado.
I knew it.
The Monado is ineffective against the Hyentia, the Homs, against all races of Bionis. Egil suffered a bitter defeat in the battle 1 year ago. After that, he theorized that he could counter the Monado by integrating organic life from Bionis.
Of course. Initially, the Monado couldn't take a Hom's life.
It can now, though.
It could not harm those who share the blood of Zanza. That was its sole weakness. But Zanza lifted that constraint.
Those who share the blood of Zanza? Who is that giant?
The progenitor of the Homs.
Him?
And once the friend of my brother, Egil, before they became sworn enemies. It was Zanza who devastated Mechonis.
What?